हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑल। टुडे वी विल नो हाउ टू राइट अ प्रैक्टिकल नोटबुक और हाउ टू मेंटेन अ गुड प्रैक्टिकल रिकॉर्ड। वी नो दैट द मार्क्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन आर एज 80 मार्क्स फॉर थ्योरी एंड 20 मार्क्स फॉर इंटरनल असेसमेंट। इंटरनल असेसमेंट इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन, सो दैट 20 मार्क्स इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड एज 5 मार्क्स फॉर प्रैक्टिकल नोटबुक, 5 मार्क्स फॉर वाइवा एंड 10 मार्क्स फॉर रिटेन प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन। सो दिस इज योर साइंस प्रैक्टिकल नोटबुक। इन दिस यू हैव टू डू एक्सपेरिमेंट रिलेटेड टू फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोलॉजी। Today I will give a sample of biology test practical. In next video we will discuss the experiment related to physics and chemistry. So before starting how to write a practical notebook, we should know some rules related to it. Before writing, we have to do the experiment related to the science in your laboratory with the help of teacher. Suppose if we are going to do the experiment of the stomata, means we are preparing a stomata mound, so we have to do that experiment in our laboratory. Then we have to write that experiment. What is the process of that experiment in a systematic way? So that is the written explanation of your science practical. For writing a science practical, you need pencil, eraser, sharpener, scale, two types of pen like blue and black. So let's start how to write a science practical. This is your science practical notebook. In this top of the book, you have to write science practical, your name, your school name, class. This is the second page. In this, you have to write your name, roll number, class, institution. In this, you have to write your school name. Here, you have to write your academic year, like 2021 to 22. This is the index page. Index page is like a list of the experiment which you are going to do. So, this is the list of the experiment. This is for the class 10th. So, here the experiment are like, this is experiment related to biology. So, first experiment is to prepare a temporary mount of a leaf peel to sow stomata. Second is to sow that light is necessary for photosynthesis. Third one is to show that CO2 is released during aerobic respiration. Fourth one is to observe winery fission in amoeba and budding in yeast. Fifth one is to study embryo of dicot seeds. Here you have to write name of the experiment. This is the serial number. Here you have to write the page number, means from which page to which page you have done that experiment. Means you have written that experiment, you have to write on that. Means I have done this experiment with 1, 2, 3 pages. So this is that. Here you have to write date of experiment. In which date you have done that experiment, you have to write that. Don't copy this too, because this may vary. Means if you are doing that experiment in 19th, 20th or before that, so you have to write that date here. And this is the date of submission, means when you are submitting your experiment to your teacher. So this is the date of submission. And these remarks are for the teacher work. So this is index page. And here are some pictures related to your science experiments are given, like electromagnetic spectrum, electromagnetic waves, visible spectrum like infrared, ultraviolet rays. This is the pH scale which is used to identify which is acid and which is base. Power of hydronium scale. This is the buoyancy force related examples are given. You can see. Okay. Here some forms of energy are given, like nuclear energy, thermal energy, electrical, magnetic, like that. See, this is your compound microscope. Microscope is that thing which can magnify any object, by which we can see that object in a larger view. So this is your compound microscope or optical microscope. Here you can see this is the eyepiece from where we can see the object which is kept in this stage. This is tube, this is body, and this is coarse adjustment knob. This is used for high and low magnification of power. By the help of this we can magnify the object. This is clips, objective, nose piece, stage, slides. Here you have to put the slides by which we can see that object. This is mirror and this is foot fine adjustment knob. Here some logarithms are given. See, this is the first page of your notebook. Don't write from here, leave this page. Start writing from this page. This is your first page of your practical notebook. So I have written here first experiment number 1. That is your first experiment. Name of the experiment or aim of the experiment, both are same. So what is that experiment? To prepare a temporary mount of a leaf peel to sow stomata. Means we have to prepare one mount which will sow the stomata. So for that, what we required leaf of a plant like Bryophyllum or Tradescantia. We can use any plant leaf, but it should be a broad. Forceps, needles, watch glass, dropper, glass slides, a brush, cover sleeves, blotting paper, saphenine, compound microscope and glycerin. That's our apparatus and chemicals are required. Then we have to write role of stomata. What is the role of stomata? Stomata are tiny pores present on the surface of leaves. It is a tiny pores which are present on the leaves and it play an important role in transpiration. Transpiration is what? It is a process in which water loss takes place. And it is the process by which what happened? Means exchange of gases happen. Stomata play an important role in exchange of gases, like intake of CO2 and outtake of oxygen. Procedure, then we have to write procedure. What is the process to doing this experiment? So first we have to pick a healthy leaf from the potted plant. Then we have to fold that leaf to gently pull the peel apart to separate a peeled section from the lower surface of the leaf. Whenever we are going to peel any leaf, we should peel that section from the lower of the leaf. For this, we can use the forceps to perform this step. Put a small pieces of peels in a watch glass. When we have cutted that pieces of peel, then we have to put that on the watch glass containing water for some time. Then we have to keep that pieces of peel in water for some time. In the watch glass, stain the sample by adding some drops of saffronin through a dropper. So after putting in water, what we have to do? We have to color that sample by using which chemical? Saffronin. Saffronin, we should use some drops of saffronin to color. Color or stain are the same. Then what we have to do? Take the peel out after 2 to 3 minutes. After coloring, we have to put out that peel after 2 to 3 minutes. Then we have to put that on the clear glass light, when another glass lights. With the help of blotting paper, what we can do, where we have to remove the excess of stain. If we have put the excess drop of saffronin, so we have to remove that. Then we have to add a drop of glycerin on the peel. So we have to add some drop of glycerin on the peel. Then put a clear cover slip over it gently using a needle. Always use equipment which are given. Don't try to do this with your hand, okay? After that, examine the slide first under a low power and then under a high power magnification of a compound microscope. So these all are the procedure to mount a peel. Then what we observe epidermis. Epidermis are the outer layer of the plant, consists of a single layer of a cell which are irregular with no intercellular spaces. Small opening stomata are scattered through the epidermal cells. Each stomata is surrounded by two kidney-shaped cells known as guard cell. What is guard cell? Guard cells are observed which are chloroplast and nucleus. Guard cells control the closing and opening of the stomata. Then we have to write conclusion. What we conclude? Epidermal cells are found containing stomata on the lower surface of the leaf. That's all. Some precaution you have to follow during the experiment. Like avoid folding the leaf too much. We should not fold the leaf too much. The peel should be snipped to a proper size. Whenever we are going to fold the leaf, that should be in proper size. The peel should always be placed at the center of the slide. If this is slide, so we have to put that peel in the center of the slide, not in the side of the slide. The peel should neither be overstained nor understained. Means if we are coloring that peel with the help of saffronin, we should not give that saffronin too much or not low. That is written. A brush should be used to handle the peel. Whenever we are going to do the peel, means we are putting the peel, we should use brush. Otherwise, it would damage cell because cells of that are very minute. They can damage. Glycerin should be used in order to prevent drying of the peel. Why we use glycerin? Because this is used to prevent the peel while drying. Cover slip needs to be placed in such a way that air bubbles are avoided. Okay. Blotting paper can be used to remove excess stain. These all are precautions we should follow. See, what the structure we have to put there? See, first we have to make the structure of opening and closing of stomata. This is the stomata structure. In the stomata structure, what are given? First is cell wall, then nucleus, vacuoles, chloroplast, guard cell. This is guard cell, which help in opening and closing of stomatal pore. This is stomatal pore. This is closed stomata. In the practical notebook, what you have to do? In the white paper, you have to draw the structure related to your experiment, and in the ruled paper, you have to write down the experiments. You know? And this is the peel of a leaf on a slide. After putting the saffronin solution or glycerin, this looks like that. And we have to observe this on a compound microscope. So this is our first experiment. Next experiment is what? To show that light is necessary for photosynthesis. For this, what apparatus are required? A potted plant, a light screen or black carbon paper, clips or sellotape, alcohol, iodine solution, water bath, beaker, burner, water, petri dish and dropper. All are apparatus and chemicals. Then we have to write some theory. Light is one of the requirements for photosynthesis. In theory, what you have to write? You have to write something about what you are going to do experiment related to that. You have to write something about that. So light is necessary for the requirement of photosynthesis. In green leaves and young stems of living plants, photosynthesis happen. And what is the product which are going to make? That is glucose is prepared from carbon dioxide and water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. With the help of chlorophyll, and oxygen is evolved or given out to this process. So this is the experiment of photosynthesis. 6CO2 plus 12H2O in the presence of sunlight or chlorophyll, it gives 6H12O6 plus 6CO2 plus 6H2O. Then what we have to write? Procedure. First, what we have written? Aim of the experiment, then apparatus, then theory, then procedure, then observation, then conclusion, and then precaution. That's all. So what is the procedure for this experiment? Take a healthy potted plant with variegated leaves. For example, we can take money plant or crotons. Keep that plant in a dark room for 3 days so that all the starch gets used up. We have to put that plant in dark room for 3 days. Because in dark room, what happened? Photosynthesis will not happen. And whatever their stored food are there, means the starch are there, so that will be used up. So they will de-starched. That's why we have to put that plant in dark room for 3 days. Now keep the potted plant in sunlight for at least 3 to 4 hours. Then what we have to do? We have to put that plant in sunlight. After keeping in the dark room, we have to put that plant in sunlight, in the presence of sunlight for 3 to 4 hours. Then after 4 hours, pluck the leaf from the plant and mark the green areas. means when we are plucking the flower from the plant, so we have to mark the green areas in that and trace them on a sheet of paper. Boil the leaf in water for about 2 minutes. Then we have to boil that leaf in water for 2 minutes. Now immerse it in a beaker containing alcohol. Then we have to immerse that leaf into a beaker containing alcohol. Then what we have to do, carefully place the above beaker in a water bath and heat till the alcohol begins to boil. So what we will observe, leaf color will start decolorize. So remove the leaf from beaker and wash it in water at room temperature. So we have to wash that leaf from a normal water. Then place this leaf in petri dish and add few drops of iodine solution over the decolorized leaf. Take out the leaf and rinse off the iodine solution. Then observe the color of leaf and compare this with the tracing of the leaf done in the beginning. The green traced part of the leaf turned blue-black with iodine solution. So what we will observe, the uncovered part of the leaf or the green parts of the leaf which we have marked, that will turn into blue-black with iodine solution. This confirms the presence of starch, as we know that iodine is used for taste of starch, and this we have done in the class 9th. The covered portion of the leaf remains yellow, means whichever portion we have not marked, that portion is look like as it is, means yellow portions. So means there is no starch synthesis occur, because we know that where photosynthesis occurs, it occurs in the green parts of the leaf. So what we conclude, this proves that light is necessary for photosynthesis. What precaution we have to follow? We always use healthy potted plant. Leaves of the plant must be made perfectly starch free by keeping the plant in darkness for at least 48 hours. Means we have to put that plant in darkness first. Then we have to put that in the light. The black paper strip should be attached tightly on both sides of leaf so that no sunlight enters in the cover portion of the leaf. Always use a water bath for boiling leaf in alcohol, as alcohol is inflammable. Wash the leaf before performing iodine test. So these are the precautions. See what structure we have to made in this. See, experiment to show light is necessary for photosynthesis. These are potted plant. We have kept this plant in darkness for 48 or 72 hours. Then this will de-starched. Whatever the starch is present in that plant, that will be used up. We have to pluck flower from this and we have to mark the green parts of the plant. So this is before and after starch test. This is the green part which we have marked. And after the experiment, when we will add iodine, what will happen? This will look like blue-black. This is looking like blue-black. And this is the green part. Here, see, procedure to decolorize the leaf and to test the presence of starch. This is the beaker containing water where we have kept the leaf, that is de-starch. First, we have to boil with water, then we have to boil with alcohol. But the alcohol should be in another beaker and water should be another beaker. So that should be like that. Then we have to wash that leaf in normal water. This is normal water. Then after washing with the help of water, we have to keep this in iodine solution. So what we will observe? We will observe that the green traced part will turn into blue-black color. See, this is the whole experiment related to that light is necessary for photosynthesis. Always mention a date and page number here. Then what the another experiment is? See, to show that CO2 is, this is experiment number 3, to show that CO2 is released during respiration in animals. We know that animals, what they do, they always take oxygen and expel CO2. So how this will prove that CO2 is released during respiration? So this is the experiment related to that. So what the apparatus are required? 2 test tubes, a cork with 2 holes, 2 glass tubes, syringe and lime water we will use. First see this structure. This is a boy which are exhaling air through this pipe, and this is the tube in this cork is fitted, and the glass tubes are connected with this cork. And here lime water, fresh lime water are kept. So what will happen? So if he is blowing the air, exhaled air, so CO2 amount is more, we know. There are so many gases, but CO2 is enrichment here, so CO2 will pass into this. So what will happen? So lime water will turn milky. Lime water has no color, but after going the CO2, it will turn milky. In another bee, this experiment, this is also cork fitted in this tube, and there are glass tubes are attached. This is the syringe. By the help of syringe, CO2 is keeping this in the lime water. So this will also turn lime water into milky. But in comparison with these to this will happen sooner in comparison to that. Why? Because we know that animal exhale air, that is enrichment of CO2. But if you are doing this with syringe, this is the low amount of CO2. So this will happen first, then this will. So for this, we require 2 test tubes, cork with 2 holes, 2 glass tubes, syringe and lime water. Finally, we have to write something about the aerobic respiration, because this is aerobic respiration. So in this process of aerobic respiration, there is absorbed oxygen from the air, which brings about complete oxidation of glucose. We intake oxygen. So what will we do? Glucose is whatever starch we are taking, whatever carbohydrate we are taking, the simplest form is glucose. After the digestion, the simplest form will happen like glucose. So glucose will combine with oxygen to give the energy. So this is the written here. So this will give CO2, H2 and ATP. So this ATP is adenosine triphosphate, and this is a stored form of energy which gives energy to us. Procedure: take some freshly prepared lime water in a test tube. Fit cork with two holes in test tube A and B. Fit two glass tubes in this cork of the test tubes A as shown in that figure. Exhale here into tube and record your observation. First, we have to observe that observation from A, then B, which has lime water pass here through syringe, and record your observation. So what we will observe? We will observe that in test tube A, the lime water turns milky sooner than in test tube B. So what we can conclude, the exhaled air contains lots of carbon dioxide, which turns lime water milky. This proves that during respiration, we exhale CO2 gas. Precaution which we have to follow during this, the glass tubes should be dipped in the lime water and the lime water should be freshly prepared. So today we have done 3 experiments related to your syllabus. First we have done temporary amount of leaf peel to source stomata, the light is necessary for photosynthesis, then CO2 is released during aerobic respiration. I have written in my way, you can write in your way, means you can take help from this experiment and you can write according to your experiment, the words can be similar or different. I have given only 3 experiments. 2 experiments you have to write with yourself, like to observe binding fusion in amoeba and budding in yeast, to study embryo of dicotyl. What you have to do? First, you have to write aim of the experiment. In aim of the experiment, you have to copy this. Then what you have to do? You have to write apparatus and chemicals required. In apparatus, you can write glass tubes or some amoeba specimen. For this experiment, amoeba specimen, you can write down like that. Then apparatus, you have to write theory. You have to write something about what is binding fusion. Binding fusion is a process of asexual reproduction which happens in amoeba and budding in yeast. So you have to write like that. Then you have to write the procedures, what we are going to do during the binding fusion in amoeba, how we observe this procedure, then what we will observe, observation, then conclusion, and then some precaution you have to write. So this is dicot seed. You have to write about embryo of dicot. There are 2 types of seed, monocot and dicot. Dicot seeds examples are like pea. So you have to write. Hope you will write this 2 experiment with yourself. And that's all for today. Thank you. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe.